And good morning to Ajay. So I am Pallavi, your host for this meeting, and I welcome you all to Friends of India and America online personality development meeting. Today is our Saturday day segment, and today we are going to talk about a very important topic, which I think it plays a very vital kind of role in everyone's life. It's all about time management. So everybody is going to share their views about the time management, how this group is helping them in managing time, what are the activities they are doing to do time management, is it beneficial, or how, if they have any other ideas, they can share their personal life experiences and so other things. So let's begin with the meeting, and I think Ashutosh in the hurry, so let's call him to be our first speaker. So let's join hands and welcome our first speaker of the day, who is Ashutosh. Ashutosh, please, you can start. Welcome.
You can turn on your camera, like, so that we can see your beautiful face, you know.
Actually, I am in my in-law's house, and I am at the house. Just see where I am.
Never mind. Wow, that's a good
one. And yeah, we can also see the celebration and all those modes.
I will show you after finishing my this one. So that's why I have turned off my camera. Because a lot of background.
Just a minute, Ashutosh. And I am going to make the note of timings today, because Ashutosh is not going to attend the meeting. And after 4 minutes, I'll give you a pointer that your 4 minutes are over. Now you have to wrap within the next 1 minute. And if you are not able to wrap, then I'll contradict and I'll call another person, another speaker. Okay. So yes, we have to finish anyhow or speak within the five minutes today.
Great, Pallavi. Thank you so much for today.
Yeah, please go ahead.
So, thank you so much, Pallavi. Today we are going to talk about time management, and my topic is good time management and how I'm doing it currently to manage my time. Before that, the first thing was, why time management? Why we require time management? That is a very important part, because that is a thing which you are going to implement in your life. So time management is, we are doing it for to make our goals more effective, and we can reach out our goals to get outcomes. That's why we are talking about time management nowadays. If you want to make a good use of your time, you have got to know what's more important, and then give it all you have got. Time management is a process of planning and exercising is on a daily basis. It is required for everyone. If you take example of any billionaires, he follow his or her routines, and he respect every single second. Why? Because for him, 1 second is equal to 1 lakh or more than that. They put work in a priority by setting a goals and prioritize them in order. They set gravitational goals, which attract actions automatically. What I am doing currently to manage time? The first thing, work on priority. Every day we are sharing our goals. We are trying to get 100% out of that. But some time is there which is going on in our mind, that some work we have to finish this by today. That is very important. Like today, my first priority is to complete my decorations and do puja of Ganesh Chaturthi, and I have to give my most time over there. Second one, create time management goals. The focus of time management is actually changing your behavior, not changing times. Good place is to start is to eliminating your personal time wasters. For 1 week, set a goal that you are going to take for that particular week. Challenging, the third one, challenge to your friends. Like the we are sharing our goals. And if I talk about me, I always try to challenge Ajay. Like not in a negative way, in a positive way. Like I have to, if I have to run, so for to complete 5 kilometers, I think I need some push so that I will complete my 5 kilometer of run. That's why I always talk with Ajay about a challenge and all. Third one, visualizing for our big goals. Whatever the goals we are set, we have to visualize from where we get a power booster. When you think big, you will do big. Visualization is something which makes you a clear picture about your goals, which I am doing on regular basis. Like 5 minutes, I am doing positive affirmations where I try to visualize all the things in my mind. And that's really boost my energy. Today, I attend this meeting just because all the positive thoughts is going inside my mind. No, I have to set a benchmark. If I will not do, then my mentees is not going to follow me. I have to be among all 4 or 5 members of active members of this group. Use time management tools, whether it's a day timer or softwares or phone.
4 minutes are over.
The first thing, physically manage your time is to where you are going now. Planning how you are going to spend your time. Last one, find out where you are wasting your time, through which you are going to analyze yourself. In survey by salary.com, 89% of respondents admit to wasting time every day at surfing, chatting, talking with friends or someone. Tracking daily time helps you to accurate picture how much time you are going to spend on various activities. Stick to your routines and try to make it possible. Get a habit of setting time limit that we are doing in a group. Your time belongs to you. I don't think of the past. The only things that matter is the everlasting present. So thank you so much.
Time out. Thank you, Ashutosh.
Thank you, Pallavi.
Thank you, Ashutosh. And so next time when we are talking on phone, it means that it is a waste of time. When we are taking the mentor mentee sessions, it's not about chatting and all.
No. Like effective chatting is not a waste of time.
Obviously. Yeah, so you talk a very good like goals, clarity, and visualizing your goals. So thank you, Ashutosh, for highlighting the main points about the time management. So now I would like to call our next speaker, who is Dilip Sharma. So let's welcome Dilip Sharma on stage. Welcome, Dilip.
Thank you, Pallas. Today, why good time management is important. So we all know that time is very important for everyone. And for success, for getting without a stressed life, without a stressed life or happy life. So the good time management is very important. In this busy life, everyone want to get success and earning more money or living without stress or happy life. So there is a question appear, that is, how do we manage our time? So the first, we have to think or observe the reason
He is not audible to me or to everyone else.
Everyone.
He's not audible.
He is not audible.
He's not audible.
Yeah, I'm also not.
Maybe
I think network issue. Yeah. Maybe network issue.
Dilip Sharma, are you there?
No. He left the group. Pallavi, okay, you can so call someone else.
Yeah, so we have to first observe where we are. If we are doing very proper way, like we can get success in every sector.
Do one thing, Dilip, turn off your video, so you will easily your network will a little bit better. If you are turn on your video, so there is network issue can be. So you can turn off your video and after that start your speaking.
It's fine. Now
you can turn off your camera because your voice is lacking. Yeah, please turn off your camera and then speak.
Now it's fine?
Yeah, fine.
Yeah,
fine.
Please speak.
So, the good time management is very important because it improves our self-discipline. If we are doing our routine in a proper way, we can get success. Second one is it improves the quality of our work. Regularly basis, like if we wake up early in the morning and it is this is a good thing, we can say this is discipline. We are regularly basis wake up. So the third one is good time management reduce our stress. If you are doing any work, if you are manage time, then it reduce our stress also. Because if you have a time, you can think and take any decision, doing your complete your job goals. So the next one is good time management. It helps our personal relationship. If we have time and we are managing very well, that it helps to.
Your 4 minutes are over, Dilip.
Okay, Pallavi. With the help of good time management, we can save our precious time, and this time we can spend with our family, with our friends. So thank you so much.
Just to add one thing, everybody, once Pallavi is telling it's 4 minutes, still you have 1 minute to wrap up, all right? So no need to hurry. Make sense, Dilip? All right, everybody, like, once you are notified, you have 1 more minute to wrap up. So no need to, like, you know, hurry up or be disordered or something. Just wanted to convey.
Okay.
Thank you, Dilip. Thank you, Dilip. So, Dilip, you talked about how to reduce stress, to wake up early, and your personal relationships. So, I think there was some lag, but you were looking confident and you delivered a good speech. But because of the internet issue, we were not able to hear clearly. That's why we were telling you to switch off your camera.
Okay.
So, from the next time, what you can do. Of a camera so that your voice will be clearly audible. That was the only concern.
Fine, because I'm not able to listen properly also. Okay, thank you.
That's no issues. So now I would like to call our next presenter, who is Hira. So let's welcome Hira on stage. Welcome, Hira.
Thank you, Pallavi. Today I am going to talk about
team management,
not the time management.
Talent wins games, but teamwork wins championships. It is a famous quote from Michael Jordan. An individual can be a successful person with his intelligence and wisdom. This can give him complacency when this individual intelligence are superimposed than team makes. It forms a team. And when this team has a determined, ambitious, confident leader like Ajay, then such team creates history. Managing a team is not an easy task like creating a team. It took lots of energy, time to manage. If you take an example of our group, after creating this group, Ajay has spending a lot of time for us. He is managing his time beyond his personal and professional life. So, team management is not an easy task. For managing a team, I would like to share some key points. First one is trust on others. It is said that teamwork begins with trust. So the team leader must show trust with all of his teammates, and at the same time, each and every member of the team must faith their leader too. Second thing, which is very important for team management, communication. There should not be any communication gap between the team members. Leader should communicate with each and every member. He needs to take opinions from other members of the team. If there is some constructive suggestion, he needs to follow those suggestions also during the team project. Third thing, identify the problems and try to resolve it within the team. Sometimes what happens during a project or achieving goals, there is some problem or there is some topic where everyone have different suggestions. At that time, leader has to decide which suggestion is best and how to react with those suggestions so that the goal can be achieved at proper time. Fourth point I would like to mention, that is command and control. Every team having a good leader always gets success. Why? Because the leader has full command over his team. If he gives any instruction to the team, each and every instruction is followed by his teammates. That's why they get success in easier way. Fifth point, give respect and take respect. This is a very important key point for
4 minutes.
Management of a team. So everyone in the team must respect each other so that there should not be any gap. Sixth point is favoritism. The team leader should not favor any personal friend or a family member if he or she is in the team. That means if you are not favoring any person, each and every member will respect you. Seventh, last point I would like to share, goals are dreams with deadline. So friends, let's achieve our common goals and flag success. I would like to conclude with a very nice quote. None of us is as smart as all of us. Thank you.
Thank you, Hira. You talked about team management. So I would like to ask Adarsh Raj. Adarsh, what do you like from the Hira speech? And you learn any important points regarding team management?
Hello? Hello?
Yes, Adarsh.
Hira Lal tell about in his speech about our group. Ajay Kumar invite every member link to join the group, and it is not a simple task, but Ajay Kumar is doing better way, and that's any or other point at touching in a speech, Hira Lal. Thank you.
Thank you, Adarsh. So he talked about how to manage a team. We talked about trust, favoritism, respect, setting goals. So thank you, Hira, for highlighting the important points, how to lead a team and how to manage a team. So now I would like to invite our next speaker, who is Kundan Kumar. Kundan, are you there?
Yes, I am here.
Yeah, Kundan, please go ahead. Welcome on
the
stage.
Hello, everybody. Thank you. So good evening, everyone, and good morning, Ajay Bhaiya. So today I am going to share with you four powerful tips for time management. Time management is very aspect in our life. If you see the people who got success in their life, they all know very, very well about time management. They manage the time very well. You know, there are two types of people. First one is monochronic and second one is polychronic. Monochronic people, they do work one by one, like one finish after that one and second and then next and then next. And second one is polychronic people. Polychronic people are very intelligent. They know how to manage the time and they prioritize the work, like first, what to do first and what to do second. They prioritize their work. And they are very intelligent and sharp in handling the thing. Now coming to the time management tips. First one is prepare to-do list. What to do, when to do, like I have to do yoga, when to do, like 6 to 7, how to do. And do you know the CEO of PepsiCo company, Indra Neo, she keeps a note always with her. Like she got any idea, she just note it down. And in that note, to-do list are very important. In the same way, also prepare not to do list. Yes, listen, not to do list. What, like you are spending more time on social media, you are chatting someone too long. These are investing your time. So you have to prepare not to do list. And Swami Vivekanand say related to it, what is poison? He said anything excess is poison. Excess money, excess power, and excess food. Everything excess is poison. Okay, and second thing, if you want to manage time, you have to always goal, like short-term goal, long-term goal. Everything comes from ambition. Third one is wake up 30 minutes early. 30 minutes makes lots of difference in your life. Like you can do lots of things without tension. And always start little bit early for any kind of work. You will be comfortable. It will give you lots of relief. And fourth thing is delegate the work. Don't take all the work on your shoulder. It is also not a good thing. In last, I am going to share one line, like past is history, future is mystery, and present is gift. So present is in our hand. So make use this present properly and invest your time in the right direction. You will enjoy your life. Thank you.
Thank you, Kundan. Great speech. till now I have loved your speech, the way you have articulated and you have explained the real world examples as well. So I love the points like the any excess is poison, we have to wake up 30 minutes early, there must be a to-do list. So thank you, Kundan, for sharing your thoughts and your points regarding time management. And just try to rehearse your speech 4-5 times so that you can make it around 5 minutes. Okay. It's almost 3 minutes speech.
Okay. See you next time.
Thank you, Kundan. Yeah, please. So now I would like to invite our next speaker, who is Ajay. So let's welcome Ajay on stage.
Sure. Thank you, Pallavi. Can you guys see me okay?
Yeah.
Yes, we are.
One second. Can you guys hear me okay?
Yeah.
Yes.
Perfect. Yes. I think Asutosh and one more presenter, Kundan Kumar, very well done job. So I will try to come up with I will fill the gaps, whatever I saw in Asutosh's speech and Kundan Kumar's speech, you know, those were the best ones. In fact, I love the Hira's one also. Time management. Time is a most precious commodity. We all know that. And time management is something I learned from Abraham Lincoln. I learned from Benjamin Franklin. And he says, don't put off anything for tomorrow, which you can do it today. All right. Don't leave anything for tomorrow, which you can do today. So I'm not going to talk about, why time management is important, probably, because enough presenters have talked about why time management is important. And we know that time management is important. But here is the question. Why don't we take action? So I'm going to give you the steps on how I do time management or why time management is so important, actually. Not on a superficial level that you have to achieve goals and you have to do visualization. When I think about time management, so what comes in your mind, guys, management? So for example, for some of you, you are using to-do list. Some of you, you don't have to-do list. Some of us have calendar. But here is the thing. If you do better time management, like Sakti is doing right now, so one result he is seeing, he's getting up at 8 a.m. What he used to do, he used to get up at 10 a.m. So, you know, that's a great accomplishment. And he is reading his books, right? So that is a step number one. Write down your goals, daily goals. That will give you clarity on what time management is. But here is the thing. Daily goals will not give you urgency. We know that time is very precious, but you'd be surprised to know people spend 1.5 hours on social media and television combined together. That's a, you know, survey. We know that, Instagram is not going to help us. Facebook is not going to help us. But we get pleasure over there, right? And attending a meeting is a pain, correct? Attending a personality. And that's the fact, to be honest with you. So I will tell you how you can convert this pain to pleasure. So number one, for all of you, is let's say that, some of you have not started your career, like Kundan Kumar or Prakash Badal, right? So if you graduate right now from your college, so what would be your salary? For example, let's say 30,000 rupees, right? And think about people. Let's say that your goal could be to make 1 lakh salary, right? After 5 years, which is like very ambitious, staying in India. But think about that and then divide that amount by 24 hours, right? And then you will get a number, correct? So for 1 minute, that is your cost. That is the cost you will, you will be having. Once you lose the time, then what you can do, if you have a home, just keep there like, okay, my half an hour is costing me 5,000 rupees, which is a lot of money, right? And once you see that, then you will get a dedication not to waste time. So that is one thing. Number two, as one presenter has mentioned about having a goals. Having goals is good. Daily goals are good, but have some long-term goals. if you have long-term goals after achieving success also, it will not stop you. For example, somebody like me, right? I'm living a life which is a dream life for a lot of people right now. But still, I'm getting up at 5:30 and going for a run and doing all the work, right? And why I'm doing it? Because I have goals. I have like what I want to do after 5 years. So have some long-term goals. What do you want to do after 5 years? What do you want to do after 10 years? And don't, if you are writing those goals, for example, you want to be a lecturer in a university after 5 years, have some pictures. Create a vision board. Vision board is the best thing. So for example, I will give you an example. You know, I have a goal of...
4 minutes are over.
Sure, I will wrap it up. I have a goal of spending 1 hour on learning technology, which I don't enjoy a lot, you know, after work. But I know if I have to achieve long-term goal, that is the only thing I have to do, right? So I have my vision board where I have pictures that what kind of house I want to live, what kind of job I wanted to do like 5 years back. I have those. So have vision board, do creative procrastination. As Kundan Kumar has mentioned, have priority. And he talked about having a notes, right? Keep a note, like all the successful people. I have my note over here. I just write it down, like all the points, you know, whatever I have learned. And then, like, for example, he talked about not spending time on a social media, right? So how you will be doing that? That is very important. So, for example, for that, I have some rules, you know, like from 9 to 5, my phone is not with me. I have my watch with me where I will get all the notifications. That is how you can, you know, do some time management. And probably I will write a blog and that will really help you. Over to you, Pallavi.
Thank you, Ajay. Yeah, thank you so much, Ajay. And I think the one who are in college and the one who is in school, Deepak Raj, Kundan, Prakash, and you are getting a very good opportunity via this platform. So make use of it. And in all the things which Ajay was saying, we have already read in the book, in the Atomic Habits, that how to manage our time, how to emphasize on things, how to make things practical. So utilize this platform and utilize your time, because we have passed from college and now I realize if I could have get the same kind of platform in my college, I would have been not now where I am. So all the things, you are getting an opportunity to make use of it. So that's only from my own part.
Sorry, Pallavi, to interrupt you. I have to go. I am running late. So I'm so sorry. Why I am dropping my call in the middle of this meeting. Call I received from someone. All the best for other speakers. And I will join you by tomorrow. Thank you so much, Ajay. And I'm so sorry that I have dropped my call today.
No issue.
Okay, Pallavi.
Yeah, please go carry on. Thank you for informing.
Thank you.
So now I would like to invite our next speaker, who is Prakash. So let's welcome Prakash on stage.
Thank you so much for me, ma'am. Good evening, everyone. I am Prakash, and my topic is about time management. So what is time management? So, you know, time management just refer to how to choose to, you know, spend your working hours to maximize your productivity and accomplish your goal. So I will share the 5 points through which we can just improve the time management. The first one is, you know, prioritizing the large part of the effective time management, that is being able to identify your most important task and spending a sufficient amount of the times each day working on them. And you know, the second point, that is designating the time management is about designate times to complete every things that you need to do, and assigning the 24 hours you have every day to the right task. So if you can effectively pay up your times with the things on your to-do list, so you will be able to just operate at the Panda mentions the levels of the success. So how you spend your days is up to you, where you are working on a project or you are watching televisions for days, you know, and
yes, are you done?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Yeah, thank you, Prakash. Your voice was not clear because I think in the background there are a lot of noises and because of the disturbances. So what you can do is you can record your audio and send to the group as well so that we can hear all the points which you wanted to highlight, because I'm not able to hear that clear voice.
Sure, ma'am.
It started well.
Okay, I will send the audio. I will send my audio in the group tomorrow.
Yeah. Sure.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much, Prakash. And now I would like to invite our next speaker, who is Shakti Sagar. So let's welcome Shakti on stage. Welcome, Shakti.
Thank you, everyone. I'm really sorry for getting late into the meeting because I was having my mentor, Jack, I was having a meeting and it was pre-planned 4 or 5 days back. So everyone had talked, I listened to everyone's speech, and today as I discussed with Jack, I am giving my
Prakash, mute yourself. Prakash, mute yourself.
Yes, my yes.
So I will be talking about time management and why it is important and how it will benefit all of us, whoever are in this group. So I will be talking about that. So first we need to understand, means for whom time is valuable. First you need to ask you to yourself, right? We need to understand that, are we valuing ourselves, right? If you value yourself, then only you will understand the importance of time. Otherwise, there will be no importance. Right, you will spend your time watching television, watching movies, doing gossips, hanging with your friends, because you are not valuing yourself. Means that you have no goals, you have no vision, you have no big picture of your life. That is why you are not valuing your time. So before understanding time management, importance of time, first you need to understand one thing that is very important. What is your goal? What is the motto of your life? What you want to become? What you want to see yourself after 5 or 10 years? This is important. Then you will automatically realize the importance of time. If you have no goals, no vision, you will never realize the importance of time. So I would like to say, it is a very common proverb that time and tide waits for no one. Time is money, time is everything, we all know, but we don't value it until or unless we get inspired, we get motivated. For example, I'm taking my example, I never valued my time, right? I never valued, means that I have to utilize my time. Before joining this group, I was not aware, you know, that there is a goal, there is a to-do task, why it is important for me. Everything was going well. I was working for 8 hours, returning back, doing nothing, doing wasting my time, watching movies, right? But when I saw my friend Ajay, I realized what is the importance of time and vision and how you can achieve success in your life. Otherwise, you will never achieve success. You will be at that level from where you started. You will never succeed in your life. That is the difference between, you know, a successful person and ordinary man. That ordinary man didn't respect himself, and because he has not respected himself, he has never respected his time. So what you can do, that first step is to just make a goal for yourself, that where what I want to achieve in my life in 5 years later down the line. Then you will start motivating, Yes, I have this vision. Now I need to utilize my time. So what is the best practice? Ajay has already given us a best practice that we should start with a small level, that is by defining a goal, daily goals. Write only two goals. Write only one goal, but make it sure that your goal are accomplished. You have achieved your goal. Otherwise, it is of no use. You are writing 10 goals, you are doing two goals. That is no use. There is no vision then. Write per day one or two goals and make it that you know you have nailed it. That will motivate you. That will give you confidence. So what is the value? That if I am good at my time management, then it is not on my personal level. It will automatically reflect on my professional level, you know, because of my commitment. I am more disciplined. If you are valuing time, that means that you are more disciplined. People will accept you as a leader. Team will value your skills, you know, that, you know, this man will deliver this product. He will do this betting. He will deliver this sale. He will deliver this sprint. He will deliver this code within a week. That means you will automatically become a leader. You will manage your professional and personal life in a better way. Just follow simple steps for currently for this group. I would like to say that here most of people are professional and young people. So I would like to tell, just start with a small step. Just write down two or three goals which you should make it sure that it gets accomplished. Second thing is that to follow Google Calendar, what Ajay has told, you know, to make a vision, to-do list, make a vision for 1 year or 2 years that I want to achieve that. And how you can achieve that, you have to find the way on yourself that, you know, that I want to do. You will start doing things on that particular goal. For example, I want to become a public speaker. So I study my, you know, everyday chapters, whatever are allocated apart from book. I watch motivational video. I watch web series, which are motivating. I watch English movies because that is my goal. And that's why I have realized that, you know, I have wasted so many times, right? So If you want, make a goal, then you will never regret. Because time is time money.
Thank you, Shakti. And I just want to add to Shakti's point that please everybody share your goals. And it's not about, I 100% agree with Shakti, it's not about sharing 10 or 12 goals and doing nothing. If you are sharing one goal, then please complete it and revert back and that message also that, yeah, nailed it or in any other form. So that everybody gets enthusiastic. Now you in this week, I'm so happy that everybody is replying that whatever the goals they have finished or the goals which have they have been missed. So it is kind of a motivation that, okay, everybody is doing a lot of things and why I am lagging behind. So please share your goals, and setting goals is very important. So now I would like to invite our next speaker, who is Ridhima. So let's welcome Ridhima on stage. Welcome, Ridhima.
Thank you so much, Pallavi. And before starting my speech, I want to mention one thing, because it's yesterday and today and day after before yesterday, I was reading many things regarding time management, and I was surprised because before it, I never gone through with that and read lots of things where are you can say they have strategy and all. So keeping those things in my mind and want to deliver the speech. I don't know how many it will impact in others' life, but yes, it's really effective in my life. I try to do whole things in a balanced way. So start with the good time management. What is good time management? In our early eras, in my daddies or my grannies, what they do, they wake up early and do their work, finish early, and after that start whole day and they have lots of time. But in 20s or 21, what we are doing, maximum time we are working on 9 hours and after that doing nothing. So how good time management is important. If you want to become successful in your life, that there should be a time management that should be in every day or every week. How we'll implement in our daily life. First, scheduler. Make a schedule for daily routine, what we are doing, or sending a scheduler, what we have to do on daily basis or for whole day. That's very important. Second thing is priority of work. Whatever work you want to do on a priority, because in morning we have a very fresh mind. So there I saw one strategy was there, that's called fresh and fried. So whenever your mind is fresh, like whenever you wake up and after do go for jog and medicine and meditation. So fresh mind, you can do your complex work. And after that, after afternoon, their mind is a little bit fried and we feel a little bit tired. So do your little complex or easy work. Then third was in planning of work. When we start our day, we have to plan our work. For there is a method like 1-3-5. Like 1 is important work. Then after 3, less important. And 5, below less important work. Whatever important work, that only in a 1 day, 1 important work. Then 3, less important work. And after that, below less important work. Then there is the goal setting. That is most important thing in our daily basis. If we have two types of goal, long-term goal and short-term goal. What is the short-term goal and what is the long-term goal? We have a long-term goal to go to the abroad or want to change our job. That's called long-term goal. But if we'll make that short-term goal, it's easy to crack our long-term goal. So always make your goal. And how to write your goal? Actually, there is a one word that's called SMART goal. That's SMART, specific, then measurable, achievable, relevant, and time foundation. What is a specific? Clear and defined desired outcome. What do you want to, that should be specific. Then measurable. There must be measurable your priorities. Achievable, whatever you write, that should be achieved within a day, within a week, or within a month, whatever goal that is, that can be short term or long term. After that, relevant, how relevant that work or that thing to your next level. Then time foundation, whatever you're writing, that should be a time bound. If you write in a time limit, like sometime I ran for this much time and all. So that should be mentioned there. And there is the important work and urgent work. That in two criteria, that in two category. If you have an important work, that should be in priorities. And after that, less important work or non-important work. Then there is the urgent and non-urgent and non-important. Like whatever we are doing, chit-chat, urgent work is like mailing and all, we have that, and not urgent and non-important in like chit-chatting and talking and wasting time on social media. So after that, we have to vision board. In every house, that should be very important, because there you can write your today list, how it's progress and what is done. Because okay, so what I learned from this group, I learned many things which I was not doing previously. I learned time management, very important, because before that I was not able to wake up at 5:30. Now I am doing that, and I have a dream to read a Gita, but I was not doing. Now I am doing. And try to manage time to read 3 hours or two hours. So these all are, if we have a specific goal for long term and short term, we have to start from now. Never late before, because when you start, never come tomorrow. It's my quotation, tomorrow never comes. So always do things in a today. So thank you so much. Have a great day.
Thank you, Ridhima. And thanks for laying out a nice plan, by the way, huh? It was maybe Pallavi can now.
I was surprised when I saw there are lots of code on Google. There is a Kanban list. There is a 20 and 80. I'm using Pareto, so 20 and 80 ratio. And there, so then the speech can be 1 hour or more than 1 hour because there are lots of things. And I'm surprised how what I was doing, I was wasting my whole life. Thank you so much for creating this group. I don't know others, but I'm literally beneficial of this group. Getting benefit. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Rimima. And you are motivating each and every one of us by sharing your goals and how you are actually accomplishing those goals and the way you are like benefiting by this group and you are explaining and you are giving us the feedback. So it is quite motivational. And
all my dream was in my subconscious mind. All my dream was in subconscious mind. Now then that dreams come active and I'm working for that. So thank you.
That's why I even after Ajay's speech, I talked about to the people who are in school and college, just utilize this platform. Later on, you are going to regret. And this is the thing, if actually see Ridhima and how she has started running and after how many years Ashutosh started. So make use of this platform. Share your goals, share your speeches, anything. Mentors are there. So please utilize those things which are being provided to you.
And within 30 minutes, I completed 3 hours running or jogging. That's really great for me. Mom was serious, a surprise. What are you doing day by day? Thank you.
So thank you, Ridhima. And now I would like to call our next presenter, who is Deepak Raj. So let's welcome Deepak on stage.
Thank you, everyone. First, I start with one quote. If you love life, do not waste time, for time is what life is made up of. Now, some questions are seen by the Javia, that is, what is good time management? According to me, time management is the process of organizing and planning how to divide our time between and specific activities. Good time management enables us to work smarter, not harder, so that we get more done in less time, even when time is tight and pressures are high. Now, one question, why do I think time management is important? Effective time management is the effective use of our time that allows us to plan our days in such a way that we finish our work with less effort and make the most of the limited time we have got. When we properly manage our time, we get more done, but also have more time for the activities we truly enjoy. What are you doing currently to manage our time? First, get up at the same time each day. Second, focus on self-improvement. I want to include exercise in my time also. I never focus on multitasking because I want to stop multitasking because it always confuses me. That's why. I get enough rest at night and do important tasks first and reducing distraction. That means Ajay bhi also tells social media like Facebook, Instagram, and so mobile, TV, and etc. And deliver work on time. Now, this is my first time to tell about this group. So from this group, first I learned from this group is how English language is important. Because I know in school life, but I'm not realized. I'm also search this type of platform. I present myself. So I learned from this group first how English language is important. So I always talk to anyone with English who known. And you know that I also talk with my brothers, others, Raj, with English. When he asks something, and also I ask something. And second, I also do exercise daily, which I early not do because when I in hostel I do exercise, but when I leave the exercise I forget this type of activity. But nowadays I do daily exercise 1 hour 30 minutes, and I also do all work on time, which I early do not do on work time, because I think when I free I do the work. But nowadays I am do my work on time, and also I want to learn so much things like how to become successful in life, and how to develop personal and professional life, and how to develop personality development in personal and professional life also. And I always try to think positive by this group. I always focus on do the positive work and also get a positive energy to go in the right path. At last but not least, first I would like to thank this group to give me such a wonderful opportunity to develop myself. This group so much helps me. Like, I so much thanks Ajay Bhaiya to give me such a wonderful platform to, he invites me many guests like Kiran Bhaiya and Tiffin ma'am. And also you notice that Kiran Bhaiya tell on the paper, write on the goals on paper. Yes, it's really helpful, because suppose somebody have do not phones and the mobile phones and the any technical, you can use your page and also put in a packet. When I saw which you completed, then take it, and then by this activity you can complete your work on time. And also I thanks Palvi ma'am so much as Sivaj my mentor, and I thanks so much because he always guide me, and also he told me think big, and I am happy so much to get Palvi ma'am as my mentor, because he always calls in every week and told me, Deepak, where you have to improvement in speech and personal life. That's why, because before I have not such a wonderful platform where I present, but I have the best type of a platform I present. So thanks everyone, especially I thanks Ajay Bhaiya to give me a special platform, and everyone, thank you and have a nice day.
Time is up. Thank you, Deepak.
Ashutosh, you
yes.
Ready?
For the speech, Deepak?
Yes, yes, I'm ready.
All right, go ahead then.
Yes, ma'am.
So just give me 20 seconds, Ashutosh. I was telling feedback to Deepak. So good job, Deepak. You delivered a good speech. And just the same thing, just try not to read. Okay, just rehearse and give. While facing the camera, the participant, just try not to read the whole speech. It is the only thing. Thank you, Deepak. Okay. So, I can start my timer. Yeah, Ashutosh.
Okay. Now it's time to invite our next speaker. She is a host of this group. So, welcome, Pallavi. Now, stage is yours.
I can time you, Pallavi. Not a problem. All right, go ahead.
Yeah, okay then. Thanks, Ajay. So, thank you, Ashutosh, and thank you, everyone. So, today we are talking about on time management, and everybody has spoken about their points, their goals, and setting goals, their long-term goals, short-term goals, there should be a to-do list, the priorities and everything. So, in a kind of summarizing, I would like to say that, see, God has given a kind of bank. The name of the bank is time. In every morning, we are being credited with 24 hours. And every night, the bank called time is writes off the whatever time we are unable to use constructively and productively. So the time, the bank time, it carries no credit, no overdraft, and we all have a choice that how to utilize and how to value our own time. And if any one of you are saying that I don't have the time, then the time management is the answer for you. Everybody is being credited with the 24 hours, and the managing the 24 hours of your day efficiently and balancing your both social life, work life, your sleep division, your personal life is all about management of managing the time. The Bill Gates have said that money can buy many things, but it cannot buy you an extra minute in a day. So before going to the bed, everybody should ask the three questions suggested by him to yourself, that did I devote enough time to my family? Did I learn enough new things today? Did I develop a new friendship or deepen old ones? So if you are able to answer these three things, then it means that you have utilized your time in a very efficient way. So as already everybody has highlighted the points, I just want to highlight the same points. Like, to manage time, the first thing is set your goals. Set your goals correctly and wisely. After that, you need to prioritize your goals. Suppose I am setting an exercise for 2 hours, and at the same time I have exam tomorrow, and I have allocated a study time for 2 hours. But if my exam is important, because I am having exam tomorrow, so I have to prioritize my exam, my learning. I can stretch my those 2 hours rather than I can stretching my exercise or completing my exercise goal. So in this way, you have to prioritize your goals. Set a time limit. So if for an IT person, a lot of people are doing BTech. So if you are running a code on Python or any other language, it is a time consuming thing. Sometimes a single line of code doesn't execute normally. It takes hours. So just set a time limit. Take breaks between tasks. Suppose I have decided to read 10 chapters today. So take a minimum 5-10 minutes gap in between, so that you will be like recharged or you will be refreshed. And also the thing which you are doing will not become kind of monotonous, that it is a kind of boring thing which you will feel. Organize yourself. As everybody said, start waking 30 minutes early, and I'm going to follow that. I'm going to wake up 30 minutes early from tomorrow so that I can see what the things in those 30 minutes I can utilize. Another point in the personal example, I would like to say that as one day Ajay suggested that you have to utilize your first 15, 10, 20 minutes of your day in doing something. From that day, I am after waking up, I am just sitting in the sun for the 15 minutes. I am drinking a glass of hot water. So this is now my part of routine. Every day I'm not doing anything. I have some classes to attend. I have some presentations to attend. So I'm not preparing but I have made this my routine, my daily routine, that for the 15 minutes of my 24 hours, I'm going to sit lonely and alone and going to just feel about the nature and utilize those things. Remove non-essential tasks. Like if you have allocated that by seeing other people's goals, I am also allocating that, okay, I am going to do swimming for 45 minutes, but I don't know how to swim. So first day, it is going to take more than 1 or 2 hours. So it's according to you, just remove... remove non-essential tasks from your daily routine or the goals which you are setting, and plan ahead. Suppose you are setting your goals daily, everybody is setting, so you should have a goal for the month, and then for the 2 months, then 6 months, then for the whole year, you should have a plan. I don't know the people who have joined late. Ajay shared his strategy how to plan things. So I have made a Word document. I have made an Excel sheet. And guys, please make use of Google Calendar. You don't have to write your goals also. Everything is sorted. It is on your mail. You can see. And you can edit whatever things. Suppose I have written 7 goals today. I'm not able to do. So I can automatically delete from there. And one important point is, if you are setting goals on your Google Calendar, suppose today I have not done my exercise, so it is pointing me many times. I can see that pop up. That, okay, did you do the workout today? Did you do the did it or later? So sometimes it is creating a thing that, okay, I have to finish that goal. So just keep setting your goals and plan anything. We all have 24 hours, but how the successful people are utilizing all those hours. So that's all about today and my speech.
Thank you, Pallavi. Thank you for summarizing it really well. And I hope all of us has something to learn today from all the beautiful presenters. Kundan Kumar, Riddhima, Dilip Sharma, Asutos, Hira. So I think...
Prakash.
Yeah, and here's the thing, you know, which I wanted to reinforce really quick, that whatever we talked about today, having a goal setting or time management, try to implement it actually. So right now we are reading all great books, right? So we have to think about one step beyond now, like how we can implement those in our real life. So try to break that down, what Sakti talked about, like having daily goals, and as Pallavi said, like have some long-term goals actually. That will give you a lot of energy to work actually. That will give you a lot of energy to, you know, procrastinate the things which is draining your energy, like all social media or all unattended call, which is like, you know, less important to you. So that is something to I wanted to, you know, convey to everybody. So others, Raj, I know you didn't get a time. So can you tell like what you are doing in the really, can you do an elevator speech in 1 minute probably, that what you learned from this group, you know, that would be really helpful. Or maybe I'm seeing you are writing goal of drinking 8 glasses of water, which is a lot. So can you tell like what you learned from here, you know, and what you're liking probably, that would be the last thing.
Yes. Thank you everyone. Before I am not joining this group, I have more time invest in not a proper way, but I am joining this group. I have respect of my time in life. This is managed for, I am going to morning 7 o'clock in my shop and after shutdown of my workshop, and I am coming in house 8 o'clock in evening. So I realize more time in my study. I am here. I am starting reading. So this group is very helpful with me. Thank you.
Thank you, Adarsh. I got to know from your mentor that you are busy for a month, so that's why we are not calling you for all other participants.
Maybe Dilip Ray, are you here?
That's why Adarsh is not speaking for...
Dilip Ray, are you here?
No, he is Dilip Sharma only. He has joined.
Yeah,
I am
here.
Oh,
Dilip Ray is here. Dilip Ray has joined.
So, Dilip, can you like summarize in 1 minute what you have learned from here, which is really helping you in your personal life? Just 1 minute, not more than that.
If I talk about this group.
Anything like you learned from here, which is like, you know, helping you. You have 1 minute of your time, huh?
Yes. Yeah. In this group, according to this, after joining this group, I have learned so many things. Firstly, in my entire life, I never used to wake up and go for walking at 6:30 or 6. But nowadays, I am calling to Sakti at 8 for waking up. And second, some of the speeches on a few topics like Google calendars, time management, and setting a goals. These things have helped me a lot to reduce my stress, to utilize proper timing, and to make the work done in a less possible time with a great output. And I think that these are the points which I have learned from this group. And as well as I want to mention the goal setting and making the priorities of your work in a particular schedule and list. Thank you very much.
Awesome. And we learned elevator speech from you. You just finished in 1 minute. Great job. I did yesterday. I did 30 seconds of elevator speech in Scrum meeting. Like we were left with 30 seconds, and I'm like, hey guys, I'm doing elevator speech, and everybody like, what is elevator speech, you know? So good job. Pallavi can, you know, go ahead.
Yeah, so just, I would like to conclude this. So I guess we all you have had some great learnings from today's session, and please share your goals and utilize all those things which are being shared, the important books, the people are sharing about their life stories, you are being motivated. So just keep motivated, keep yourself motivated, and just share your goals and manage your time, because it is never going to come back. So I thank you everyone. Today we are done with good. We have almost 10 speakers today with this new rule of 4 minutes reminder. We are done with the 10 speakers, and apart from that, I had also talked a lot about summarizing other people's speeches, and two of the other participants, Adarsh, Raj and Dilip, has also utilized 2-3 minutes. So we are doing good. We are only 10 minutes late today. So great. So thank you everybody today for joining today's meeting. I hope you all guys have great learning today.
Thank you guys.
Thank you so much.
Have a good day, Ajay.
Somebody was telling something.
One thing I just want to... especially for the today's meeting, I really very appreciate, because today's it was a random topic, so it right. is so yeah. So I just want to say that for every Saturday or Sunday maybe. So just random agar koi bhi topic, so we just enjoy and it is so.
We'll take into consideration, don't worry. Thank you everybody. Yes. And I have to go right now, and everybody has to go. So thanks for joining. Yes.
Thank you. Yeah.
Yep. Thank you. See you guys tomorrow. Tomorrow is 6 p.m. All right. Make sure that
6 p.m. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Bye for now.